There are many challenges to overcome when bending sides using a heating blanket. One of them is how to control the temperature during the bend. The silicone heating blanket was a huge advance in technology over using light bulbs as a heat source. The problem, though, is just how to achieve and maintain a constant temperature throughout the bend. LMI has solved this problem with a temperature controller. This is much more than just a rheostat. This controller, with the use of a thermocouple, allows you to set a target temperature and maintain it within a degree or two while bending your sides. The advantage is you can dial in the exact temperature needed for the species of wood you are trying to bend. It also allows you to maintain a desired temperature after the bend to reduce spring back. Here's how it works. When making your sandwich of metal slats and wood in the bender, place the end of the thermocouple between the wood and the heating blanket. You only need to insert it about a half inch. The other end of the thermocouple is plugged into the temperature control box. The green switch turns on the power to the controller. The red switch turns on the power to the heating blanket. This switch is red for a reason. You should never leave the setup unattended when that switch is on. In my shop while bending, I turn off the phone, radio, and any other distraction so that the process has my full attention. As an extra precaution, I even unplug the temperature controller when finished bending. A few guys have had close calls or even burned down their shops bending sides, so make sure it doesn't happen to you. Use the up and down arrows to set the temperature you want to bend the wood at. I'm going to set mine at 300 degrees. When I turn on the red switch, the red numbers, which indicate the temperature of the heating blanket, begin to rise. The controller checks the blanket temperature with the thermocouple every quarter second. As the blanket reaches the target temperature, the controller cycles the power to the blanket on and off to first stabilize and then maintain the blanket temperature at the preset target. You may notice that the temperature passes the preset temperature slightly. This is normal, and the controller will recognize this and stabilize it at the predetermined target. When I bend my sides, I start bending before I reach the target temperature, and am usually done by the time the controller has stabilized the temperature at my predetermined setting. The entire process takes me less than 5 minutes. Speaking of time, as an extra security measure, I use a timer to make extra sure I maintain my focus on the task at hand. This timer also works well for timing reheating cycles. Once you are through bending, you can turn off the red switch and monitor the cooling. The temperature controller comes from LMI preset for using with the large size bending blankets. It can also be used with smaller repair blankets like the fretboard extension and bridge blankets. However, it will need to be tuned to be used with these blankets. The temperature controller has an auto-tune function for doing this. Set up the heating blanket you want to use with the thermocouple. Set the target temperature and turn on the red switch. Once the blanket is at the target temperature, press and hold down the right arrow key until the ATM indicator light starts flashing. The controller is now auto-tuning. When the flashing stops, the controller is tuned for the new setup. Bending sides can sometimes be an intimidating process, especially when bending that expensive set of sides. The LMI temperature controller allows me to remove some of the variables in the side bending process and get consistent results every time.